So here we have the Ford Fiesta 1-litre EcoBoost Titanium X Nav on a 17 plate. I'm going to start by showing you around the outside of the car and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside you can see that it's a 5-door car with alloy wheels and tinted windows. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of the car from there. As we approach the back of the car, you'll see we've got reversing sensors, plenty of boot space as well, along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car now, and then I'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of the car, you can see that it's in fantastic condition the whole way round and really suits this colour as well. Just briefly before we climb in, I think it's well worth seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. As you can see, you get full leather seats. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that right now. Okay, so now that we're inside the car, we're going to start off with the dials. On the left-hand side, we've got the rev counter. On the right-hand side, we have the speedometer. And then in the middle at the bottom, we've got the fuel gauge. You can see above that, the total miles for this car are 12,206. That information can be changed using buttons on the end of the indicator stalk. So there's various different bits of fuel economy info available to you, all the way back round to the beginning again. If we back out to the steering wheel, on the right-hand side, we've got cruise control, and on the left-hand side, we have stereo controls, as well as that button in the middle, which is the voice activation for the phone. So hit that button, ask it to dial anyone in your contacts list, and you can do that without taking your phone from your bag or your pocket. That is, of course, once the phone is paired, and that is done over on the central screen area and stereo area just here. So before we come back to the phone, I just want to talk about the radio. So this car's got AM radio, as you can see. It also will have FM radio and DAB digital radio as well. So plenty of ways to listen to music via the radio. On top of that, there's a couple of other ways to listen to music. So you have a CD player on this car. There is a USB input. And as you can see on the screen there, Bluetooth audio. So once you pair a phone, not only can you make and receive phone calls, as I mentioned, but you can also listen to your music wirelessly via Bluetooth audio as well. And all the buttons I was pushing to go through that are just down the side here. You can access satellite navigation from there. There's a full video showing how the satellite navigation works on our website and on our Facebook page. It's well worth checking that out. Working our way down from there, we've got the climate control. So you can adjust the temperature with this dial, fan speed over here on this dial. When you're happy with the temperature and fan speed, hit that button to turn the air conditioning on, or hit auto, and the car will maintain 22 degrees by taking control of the fan speed itself. You can override that just by readjusting the fans accordingly. We also have a heated front screen and heated rear screen as well. And then below that, we can turn off the stop and start. So this car's designed to cut out in traffic to save you fuel. Pushing that button will turn that system off should you wish to. And then right at the bottom there, we got both heated passenger and driver seats on this car. We lastly have a 5-speed manual gearbox, a 12-volt charging socket underneath here, and then the USB input that I mentioned previously. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.